Hi everyone, it is Niall and Tomas from niallpoints.com and we are back with the Eurovision 2024 Song Contest Reviews. Today we are going to look at Poland, who have internally selected Luna and the song Tower. So let's take a look at the music video and see what we think. I like the sort of angelic feel.
Yeah.
Waiting for a sun to catch me. Gotta find a way back home.
I also like the beat. It just grabs you instantly.
Hoping for a star to fall. Something I can make a wish on. Could it be that I'm not full? But we all.
Okay. Speeding up. That's nice.
I really love the visuals in this music video. It's beautiful.
That's not how you play chess.
Always try to chase a rainbow and never found a pot of gold. Below.
I feel like I wanted to go somewhere more a little bit.
I don't know, I quite like this. Just soft and smooth. So I wonder, is that supposed to be her in like so many years, or the older woman?
Maybe. Okay, you are getting a little bit more energy in this final chorus, but I just need it cranked up a bit. Okay, so okay. That was Luna and the Tower. Tomas, let's start with you. What did you think?
I really like this. This is actually one of the songs that I put on my playlist. So I'm listening to this song quite a lot, actually. I just love the vibe of it. It's such a smooth, soft, calm song. I don't know how to explain it. It just makes me feel at ease. It makes me feel comfortable. I don't know. I just love the sound of it. I also kind of like I like the beat and sort of like the fast pace, like, I don't know, like the what do you call it, like the drum and bass sort of kind of thing that's going on. I like the visuals of this music video. I think they're very pretty. I think the dancers scene is something that they could do in Malmö as well. They can just sort of like copy that. I wrote down at some point, like, she kind of reminds me of what is her name, the mother of the Addams Family,
Morticia.
She's got like a blonde version where she's got like the slicked back long hair. She's gorgeous. Like, she's got a very unique look. Her eyes are stunning. She's a stunning girl. I do agree when you say, like, it doesn't really go anywhere in the sense that it's very linear. Like, it doesn't really have any, like, a lot of ups and downs, except for the last part, which is a little bit, you know, there's a little bit more happening there. But for me, that doesn't really, that's not really a bad thing. It doesn't really bother me, because especially in a sea of violence that we have already at Eurovision, it could possibly stand out. It's also very radio friendly, so I think it's something that could potentially do well with the juries if she sings it well. And I also really like that visual, like, it was more towards the end when she had, like, the red and white, like, sort of, like, ribbons that were, like, tied around her neck, and they were doing that little dance. It reminded me of that Girls Aloud video, Sexy No No No. Do you remember that? That music video. It sort of reminded me of that a little bit with the veils and stuff like that. And I feel like visually there's also a bit of a story here. So she's obviously, she's playing chess with, I don't know who it is, someone, some guy, some girl, and then some older woman. And then she, in the beginning of the music video, in the part where she does the dance, she's dressed as like a pawn or like the queen in of the chess game, whatever you call it. So I kind of like that as well. So I'm really a big fan of this entry. It's in my top 10, and I think it could potentially stay there.
Okay. Now, I don't dislike the song by any stretch of the imagination. I do think it is a good song. I think it's packaged well. I agree with you that it's radio friendly. There's a couple of things that just don't sit right on me and my tastes. Mm. I find her vocal, although very good, I find it very sort of sugar-coated. I think it's very, like, sugary pop, like it feels almost a little bit fake, like the accent of it, almost, like, I don't know how to describe it. It's just tonally, it just
I know what you mean. There's a bit of an accent there that sort of, I know what you mean. Yeah,
there's just something that feels inauthentic about the actual tone of the voice within the song for me. That doesn't mean her voice is bad, it just doesn't sound like how I would fully want it to sound. And again, this is my problem with this song in general. I need more power from it a little bit. Like, I do like the softness, especially at the start, or like that sort of atmospheric build that it has right before the song kicks in. I like that it then goes into poppy. I just feel like I would probably prefer it if the second verse and chorus went a little bit tougher, and then the third chorus, verse and chorus went a little bit tougher still. I feel like it takes till that third verse and chorus for it to really try and give it some oomph. And for me, it only gets halfway there. Like, it's a nice beat, it's a good beat. It's just not... We all know I'm not the biggest fan of a slower song, and to me it just feels a bit too slow, especially compared to her vocal. I think her vocal is very quick. There's a lot of lyrics in there that she's getting out very quickly.
Yeah, it's a lot of syllables.
There just seems to be, the music doesn't quite catch the pacing to me. Like, I want just a touch more energy, just a little more energy, please. That's really all I have to say on it. Like, nothing bad about it. Just there's things that for my taste could be improved. But my taste is my taste. And not everyone's going to want to replicate that.
The thing is, do we think that these are things that they will improve? Because I feel like the song is... It doesn't sound anything like a demo version or something that would do well with a revamp or something. So I don't know if what you're saying is going to be improved by me.
No, I don't know what's going to happen. We have to remember that TVP and Poland have been going through some crisis because there's been a political change in Poland, and there was accusations of bias throughout the organization. So there was a lot of dismissals going on, a lot of shutdowns at one point of news output. And this year, they internally selected via a committee. So it's a little bit different for Poland, I think, in terms of going through that route rather than doing any national selection.
And even still, with that internal selection, there was still a huge uproar.
Of course, because there was a favorite.
Luna,
there was a favorite, and she lost out by 1 point. But that's just how it works. But I think for me, I think the issue is obviously this was created. So the whole music video, the song was created without TVP involvement at all. So this is the finished article before it even got submitted to TVP.
Yeah.
And that's why it doesn't feel like a demo, because this is a released song. This was a song that was released prior to them opening submissions. So can you change it? Probably you can, but will you change it? I'm not sure. But again, the issues that I had were my taste. Like, that's unique to me. Everyone else has their own taste. And as I say, whether or not you do change that thing or improve on that thing, it's still a good song. It's still going to do well. I just want a little bit more from it personally. I think it will qualify, and I think it will do well. I would say bottom left-hand side of the leaderboard, personally. But yeah, I think it's a solid entry for especially a broadcaster who's going through a lot of change and a lot of uncertainty. I think it's a really decent entry.
I want to ask you a question, and this is probably going to sound rude, so apologies.
I'm sure I'm used to worse from you.
Do you think this is going to end up bottom of the left-hand side because of the song or because it's Poland?
I think because of the song. I think Poland do tend to do fairly well at Eurovision. We've only seen one or two non-qualifiers in recent years. Blanca, who was ridiculed by the fandom, qualified fairly easily in her semi-final last year.
And did quite well with the televote as well.
Yeah, and we have to remember, Poland has a huge diaspora throughout the continent. So televote-wise, not an issue. I don't think there's anyone who's going to be going, like, I'm not going to vote for this because it's Poland. For me, I just don't see it.
That's not really what I meant. I meant, is it going to, because I personally, as a song, although I love the song and it's in my top 10, I don't really see it ending up on the left-hand side of the scoreboard.
Oh, okay.
Just because it might be a little bit too linear. It's not really a song made for Eurovision. And we've had that discussion before. It doesn't have to be made for Eurovision, but it's very linear. It's very radio-friendly. A bit like what Germany's doing, a bit like what I was going to say Latvia, but Latvia is pretty much made for a big stage. But you know, those kind of songs that tend to do very well on the radio, but sort of get forgotten on a big stage. I mean, look at Armenia, Rosalyn, who scored a huge hit after Eurovision, and she came 22nd in the final, barely scraped through to the final, which is basically quite similar vibe. It's also that was also like a very like slow and sort of like soft, smooth song. So I don't really think that song wise this has a lot of potential. I think if it ends up on the left hand side of the scoreboard, it will be because of the televote and it will be because of diaspora.
Okay, so I'm not the one who's going to be getting any hate from this video. Okay, happy.
No,
with
but
that.
I think I don't, I it doesn't even need to get any hate. I think every Polish person knows that they have a lot of diaspora. That's not a bad thing. You're just lucky to have that. I mean, if you have it, if you can get it, take it. I mean, it's fine. It doesn't bother me. But that's why I asked the question, do we think it's going to end up left-hand side of the scoreboard because of the song or more because we know that they tend to do well with the televote? I mean, who expected Blanca to do that well last year? Let's be real. That's not because of the song. It's because of the fact that Poland has a lot of televote. They usually do.
I would say that if the song had those changes that I'd said, I would have thought it would be in the top 10. So I am going to stick by the fact that I think potentially sort of 12th, 13th, 14th because of the song. It just misses something a little bit for me, and that's why I bring it down. I'm not even thinking too much about who's actually, I'm just seeing where can I actually see it placing, and that's sort of how I envision it.
I think I would have agreed with you, for example, last year or anything, but I feel like, as we've said before, the level is so high this year. This is an exceptionally strong year. I think most people will agree. There's so many great songs. I usually tend to have like 3 or 4 songs on my playlist each year. There's a couple of others that really? I enjoy watching, but I usually only listen to 3 or 4 songs per year, you know, songs that will remain on my playlist. I think I've got like 12, 13 songs already, and that's not even including the ones that didn't make it to Eurovision. So it's a very strong year, sonically. So that's why I'm sort of like, I don't know if this song, even though I love the song, I don't know if it's strong enough to reach the left-hand side of the scoreboard on its own. It might, but...
Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. You're a bigger fan of the song and don't think it'll do as well as I do, who isn't as big a fan. So I think that's quite interesting too. So, yeah.
Maybe it's also because my favorites don't, like, they tend not to do very well. So maybe you're worried, I'm just preparing myself.
You're worried it's cursed. You're worried that Sarah Sipola is going to happen again.
Oh, don't even get me started on that.
Okay, speaking of Sarah Sipola, all of her UMK videos are up on the channel as well. You can watch them along with all of these videos we're doing for the Eurovision Song Contest. You've got more information at niallpoints.com and on niallpoints blog on Twitter and Instagram. You can follow me at niallpoints on Twitter and Instagram.
And you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at paidatomelihuya.
And we will see you next time. Bye.
Bye.